Remember Clippy, that quirky little assistant on Microsoft Word that'll just pop up and ask, do you need help with that? Well, imagine Clippy grew up, got smarter, and worked on any software. Google AI Studio is like Clippy's older, cooler sibling that works with any software. It's like having a tutor sitting right beside you, getting you instant answers, real-time feedback, and walking you through how to learn any software. It's going to make your learning curve much shorter and make your tasks easier and faster. Best of all, it's free. So how do we get started with this futuristic Clippy? Well, first things first, we're gonna head over to the Google AI Studio website. I'll leave a link in the description below. Then you're gonna go ahead and sign in. Now hold on, you might be thinking, what the heck is Google AI Studio? Google AI Studio is the next generation tool built to create, train, and deploy AI solutions built with Google AI technology. But don't let that intimidate you. You don't need any coding skills. You don't need any technical skills. You can jump in and start using it as a user. This way, you can experiment with all the different tools that are being created. All right, once you're in, on the left side, you're going to see a menu. Click on Stream Real Time. This lets you interact with the AI in real time, whether you're typing, speaking, using video, or sharing your screen. That's right, you can show the AI exactly what you're working on, and it will give you feedback. It's almost like having a personal assistant right by your side. And trust me, this is exactly what we've been waiting for. A future where you can get instant help when you need it. Learning new software can feel especially daunting, but having a tutor right beside you, helping you along the way, giving you real-time feedback, well, that definitely makes it a lot easier. Now at the bottom of the screen, click the mic icon so that the AI can listen to you. The next step is to share your screen, which is just as easy as clicking that button, and then you can select camera if you want the AI to be able to see you, or select share screen if you want the AI to be able to see your screen. I'm going to select share screen, and then I'll select my second screen so that the AI can see exactly what I have open and help me with it. Hi.
Hi there. Is there anything I can help you with today?
Yeah, can you see my screen?
Yes, I can see your screen. It looks like you have Google AI Studio open. Do you have any specific questions about it?
I'm going to show you an Excel sheet. I'll need some help with that.
Okay, I understand. I'm ready when you are to show me the Excel sheet and tell me how I can help.
Can you see my Excel sheet now?
Yes, I can see your Excel sheet. It appears to have employee data with columns for employee ID, name, status, full/part-time status, department manager, start date, and last login. What would you like help with?
Yes, exactly. I need help counting how many people have completed the training. Can you tell me how to do that?
Sure, I can help with that. To count how many people have completed the training, you need to count the rows where the status column shows completed. Would you like me to guide you through how to do this within Excel?
Yes. Can you tell me a function that I can use to be able to calculate that?
Yes. You can use the COUNTIF function to count the number of completed trainings. The formula would be equals COUNTIF, CC, completed. This formula will count all the cells in column C that contain the word completed.
Can you tell me step by step?
Okay. Let's go step by step. First, select an empty cell where you want the count to appear. Then, type equals COUNTIF in that cell. Next, click on the column C header to select all the cells in that column. Then, type a comma and the text completed in quotation marks. Then close the parenthesis so it will look like this equals COUNTIF, CC completed. Finally, press enter. This should give you the number of completed trainings.
Okay, awesome. Now I'd like to calculate how many people have not completed the training.
Okay, you can use the same COUNTIF function, but this time looking for not completed. The formula would be equals COUNTIF, CC, not completed.
Do I still need to put non-completed in quotation marks?
Need to put not completed in quotation marks because it's a text string that Excel needs to recognize as the criteria for the count. If you don't use quotes, Excel won't understand what you are trying to count.
I've gone ahead and calculated how many people have completed the training and how many people have not completed the training. Now I'd like to present this visually. Can you give me some ideas?
Sure, I understand. You've calculated the number of people who've completed training and the number who have not, and now you'd like to present this data visually. I can help with some ideas for that. Do you prefer to use a chart or a table?
I'd like to use a chart.
Okay, a chart would be a great way to visualize your data. There are several types of charts that could work well. Would you prefer to use a pie chart or a bar chart?
I like a pie chart.
Okay, a pie chart is a good choice for showing proportions. Would you like to see an example of how that might look with your data?
Can you tell me how I can go about creating it?
Sure, I can help you with that. In Excel, you can create a pie chart by first selecting the data you want to use, then navigating to the Insert tab and selecting the pie chart option. Would you like me to elaborate on any of these steps?
No, I think I got it. Can you tell me how I can go ahead and change the colors of the pie chart?
Yes, I can help with that. To change the colors of the pie chart, you can click on the chart, then go to the Chart Design tab. From there, you will see Change Colors options. Does that work for you?
I don't like any of the colors suggested here.
Okay, if you don't like the suggested colors, you can customize them. To do so, double-click a slice of the pie chart, and this will open the Format Data Series options on the right-hand panel. There, you can choose a specific color for the chart. Does that work for you?
Let me try it. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Is there anything I can help you with today?
Can you see my screen?
Yes, I can see your screen. The current slide shows a PowerPoint presentation titled The Future Factors AI and lists three key points: straightforward, practical content, and short and engaging.
I'm looking for some help making the slide a little bit more visually appealing and more impactful. Can you help me with that?
Okay, I understand. You're looking for help to make the slide more visually appealing and impactful. There are several ways to do that, like adding images, changing the font style, or incorporating some color. What kind of changes do you have in mind?
Can you give me suggestions for some images?
Sure, I can suggest some images. Since your presentation is titled The Future Factors AI, how about including images that represent artificial intelligence, such as abstract images of circuits, robots, or digital brains? Would you like any more image suggestions?
I could use that as a background, but what about the different points?
Okay, you want to use AI-related images as a background, and you're wondering how to make the points more visually appealing. How about using icons or symbols to represent each point? For straightforward, you could use a simple arrow or a straight line. For practical content, a hand holding a tool or a document icon would work well. Finally, for short and engaging, maybe a speech bubble or a clock icon would be appropriate. Would these ideas work for you?
Yeah, that works. Thanks so much.
Hi there. What can I help you with today?
I'd like to add a camera blur effect to my video. Can you help me do that?
Sure, I can help you with that. To add a camera blur effect, you'll want to look in the effects panel, and then under video effects, there should be one called blur and sharpen. Do you see it?
Yeah, I found blur and sharpen. What do I do next?
Okay, now you should click and drag the camera blur effect from the effects panel onto the video clip that you want to apply it to in the timeline below. Did you do that?
Got it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Now you should see the effect applied to the video. Do you want to adjust any settings for the blur?
That's all. Thanks.
It looks like you have Canva open.
So I've never worked with Canva before, and I'm trying to create a YouTube thumbnail.
Sure, I can help you with that. Do you want to start with a template or from scratch?
From a template would be great.
Okay, let's start with a template. On the Canva homepage, you should see a row of options, and one of them says YouTube thumbnail. Do you see it?
Yes, I just selected it.
Great, you should now be on a screen with a blank canvas and some template options on the left. Do you want to browse through the templates, or do you already have an idea of what you want your thumbnail to look like?
How can I find a template that works for what I need? My topic is about AI tools.
Okay, you want a template for a YouTube thumbnail about AI tools. At the top of the templates panel, there's a search bar. Type AI in there and hit enter, and that should bring up templates related to that topic. Do you see the search bar?
Okay, so I see a number of really good options, but I can't quite choose. Can you help me pick one?
Of course I can help. Could you tell me more about what your video is about and what kind of vibe you're going for? This will help me narrow down some options.
Yeah, in this video, I'm going to talk about different AI tools and different use cases for them.
Okay, so the video is about different AI tools and their use cases. Since it's educational, let's look for a template that is clean and informative rather than overly flashy. There are a few templates with titles like AI tools or artificial intelligence. Can you see any that fit that description?
What do you think of this one?
That template with the title, Best AI Tools, looks like a good option. It's clear and attention-grabbing. Do you like it?
I do. Can you tell me how to edit it?
Yes, I can definitely help you with that. To start editing, you can click on any element in the template, like the text, the photo, or the graphics. Once you've clicked an element, you can use the editing tools that appear above the canvas to change its size, position, color, and more. Would you like me to start with editing the text?
Can you tell me some best practices for creating YouTube thumbnails?
Sure, here are a few best practices for creating YouTube thumbnails. Use high-quality images that are clear and relevant to your video topic. Make sure the text is easy to read at a small size, and use contrasting colors. You also want to keep your thumbnails consistent with your branding, and ensure they accurately represent the content of your video, as this will help attract viewers. Do you find this helpful?
Yeah, do you think this thumbnail fits that criteria?
Yes, I think it fits the criteria quite well. The image is clear, the text is readable, and the colors contrast nicely. The design also feels modern and tech-related. Do you like the overall look and feel?
I do. Thanks so much. Clippy was cute, but this is going to completely change the way that we learn new software. Just bear in mind that Google AI Studio can see your entire screen, so make sure you're not sharing anything sensitive. So, what do you think? Are you going to try it out? What would you use Google AI Studio for? Let me know in the comments below. And hey, don't forget to click subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.